Children, in favor to protect the wildlife, many national parks and wildlife sanctuaries have been established by the Indian government. Let's define the national park and the wildlife sanctuary. National parks. The national parks are well demarcated reserved area for the protection of wildlife. It does not allow any human activity. Means the collection of firewood, timber from any part of the forest is totally prohibited in national parks. For example, Gir National Park and Periyar National Park. Now, wildlife sanctuary. Children, wildlife sanctuary is a geographical area meant for the conservation of biodiversity. In this area, limited human activities are permitted, means people can collect firewood, timber and medicinal herbs in a moderate amount, which can be used for the research and educational purpose. Children, the UNESCO has selected Manas Wildlife Sanctuary of India as a World Heritage Site. Some other examples are Ramsagar Wildlife Sanctuary and the Rajgir Wildlife Sanctuary. Let me focus on the Wildlife Protection Act 1972. In India, Wildlife Protection Act of 1972 prohibited poaching, hunting and trade of wildlife. Children, it means the 3 points to keep in mind. First is, hunting and poaching of wildlife animals and birds have been banned. The second is, killing of wildlife is a punishable offense. And the third, national parks and wildlife sanctuaries are being set up in different parts of the world. And one another fact is, in 1973, Project Tiger was launched in India with the aim to conserve tigers. Now, Jim Corbett National Park of Uttarakhand is a famous tiger reserve of India.